and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, we're going to set up this fuel injector cleaner that I just bought so I can take an injector that looks like this, grind the end off so it looks like this, and see if they flow about the same. Because I'm stupid. Let's go!
So you'll notice I collected a pile of injectors here. From pick and pull, they're cheap, and you can decap them all, but the chance of finding a set that match is slim. So you take off the O-rings, put a little bit of some kind of lubricant on there, a half inch or 13 millimeter socket fits pretty good to make it a nice little snug fit. Go over to your belt sander, disc sander, grinder, whatever you want. The disc sander will sneak up to it a little bit better. Hold it gingerly with your fingers, place it at about, 45 degree angle, and just kind of zing along. This is the very, very first injector I decapped, which is why I'm checking it a couple times and taking my time on it. I want to sneak up to this. And I'm just using a cordless drill. If you're paying attention to what you're doing, you can see when the diffusing cap just kind of zings off the end and flies off into oblivion. These injectors have a teeny tiny plate that has a bunch of holes that diffuse the fuel, turns it into a nice atomized mist, which is better for economy. It helps the fuel vaporize faster and burn better for efficiency. But if you remove that, it increases the flow capacity like 2.5 times more. So here it is. Now you can see the pintle, the little diffuser cap is gone. So that guy's done. So here's one. There's a diffuser cap. I think there's like 4 holes in it. You can't really see it. You put it on there, zippity-doo-dah, until you see the little disc fly off, or just check it. And then when the pintle is exposed like that, she's decapped, man. That's all you got to do. So I bought a full set of these from Pick and Pull so I could hopefully find a set of 8 that flow the same, which is why one of the reasons I bought the fuel injector cleaning machine is it's cheaper for me to buy that machine at like $300, $400 than it is to send injectors out to get them cleaned and flowed. Locally, a guy will do them for like $45 per injector. It won't take too long before it's cheaper just to buy the machine and do it yourself. Not as high quality a machine, I'll admit, but it works. I do have a video of cleaning injectors, and with all of these, I ultrasonically cleaned the mother-loving snot out of all the injectors and backflowed them and forward-flowed them, and I spent hours testing all these injectors until I could get a set that flowed the same. So I have a little drawer in my tool area workbench with injectors, and they're all labeled for what they flow. So if in future I need another set of 8, I can probably pick out 8 that flow. So it worked fairly well. And I do delight in having this fuel injector cleaner. I think they've redesigned this machine since. Whatever, they all do the same thing. But here we are, running them all the way up. You want to be within 2% of each other. That's kind of your goal. So you can't just throw these injectors in and have at it. The computer needs to know how big the injectors are because it does a lot of its math based on what it assumes these injectors flow. So if you're smart, you bought injectors from somewhere that gives you the flow values. If you decapped your own, you got to kind of figure stuff out. So in my case, what I did is I'm using HP tuners on this car. This is the original tune from a 2007 Chevy van. That's what my drivetrain came from. We're going into engine. We're going to fuel. We're going to flow rate versus kilopascals. And originally, this did not have a referenced, a boost or vacuum referenced fuel regulator. That's why it kind of rises as you lose vacuum. But I've changed that. So what I did is I punched in what these typically flow, and lots of interweb information on what these decapped injectors typically flow. And then I set it all to 72 or thereabouts on mine. And because my fuel system now references vacuum and boost, you set this at one steady rate in here because it takes care of vacuum and boost and makes it consistent. So I put it at what I figured it would probably flow, fired it up, and then looked to see what the short-term fuel trim was doing. And if the engine was doing a lot of correction, I changed the flow values until there was very little, if not any, correction. And then this was the number that worked out for me. It's about 72 pounds, I think. Yeah, about there for my injectors. And that's it. It fired right up. Turn of the key, ran perfectly fine. There's other tuning we needed to do for boost, but that was it. I didn't have to change anything in here. Some say you need to change the offset a little bit. I haven't. I've been driving it for 1,500 miles so far, daily driving it, tuning it for boost, and it's working absolutely wonderfully. So it seems to be pretty easy. We'll do another video in the future on what I did to tune this thing for boost, but that's injecting your injectors. Injecting your injectors. Don't inject injectors. Decap them. It works pretty good. As always, thanks for watching. Take care, and we'll see you again.